Termagants are the rank and file of a Tyranid army, and there's nothing cooler than seeing loads of them swarming across the battlefield towards your opponent, unless, of course, you happen to be that opponent. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint one in the colour scheme of Hive Fleet Behemoth. And even though I'm only painting one, I recommend you paint the whole unit at the same time. Now, all the methods and techniques I'm going to show you in this video will be useful not just for Tyranids, but for loads of other models too. So, let's get to it. A great way to paint a unit such as Termagants is to apply as many base colours as possible and then shade them all at the same time. This is a really efficient way of doing things. And in this case, I'm going to start out by painting the skin, and the colour you need for this is Mephiston Red. Now, as always, give your paints a good shake before you use each colour, and I'm going to be applying this using a large brush, because for this first stage, you don't need to be that neat, because we're going to be painting all the other areas later on anyway. So for this first stage, you just need to paint the skin. So get some paint loaded on your brush and put it on your palette, then add just a little bit of water to it to thin it down. Now this means the paint will apply smoother onto the model and go a little bit further too. So get some loaded on your brush, not too much, about that is perfect. And all you got to do is start applying this to your miniature over all the skin. And as I say, it can be quite messy at this point because we're going to be painting the other bits anyway. But as you're doing this, you'll still be able to see some of that black undercoat showing through. And this was Chaos Black Spray I used to undercoat this. And you can see some of the black showing through just around there. That's absolutely fine. Just wait for this coat to dry, then apply a second coat afterwards. It's always best to apply your coats thinly like this, rather than in one go thickly, because that way you avoid clogging detail. Once you've finished the first base colour, we can move on to the next stage, and for this the colour you need is Skavenblight Dinge. Now this is going to be for things like his hooves, his claws, and also his gun, so do all these parts at the same time. Now the brush I'm using is my standard brush, and when I get the paint ready on the palette this time, I'm just going to take a moment just to twist my brush along the palette like this, and this brings all the bristles to a nice point, which gives me lots of control over what I'm about to do for this next part, because you need to be neat now. So I'm going to be looking at things like the hooves here. So notice as I'm doing this, I'm just being careful not to get this on any of that red skin that's just around the top of the hoof there. But you probably will need to apply more than one coat of this once again to get a solid colour. So you need to do the hooves, and these little claws down here, and also his gun, and be especially careful on the gun because of his fingers. So now I've finished with the Skavenblight Dinge, and I just want to quickly point out there are some smaller claws I painted as well. There are these little ones on the backs of his legs just up there, and also there are some fingernails on his hands as well, so make sure you get those two parts as well. Once you've done them all, we can move on to the next colour. Now this next colour is going to be Zandri Dust, and this is for his teeth, so you'll need a fine detail brush to apply this. So get your paint ready once again, and I'm just going to thin it down, a bit too much water there, thin it down a little bit, and make sure I don't have too much on the brush. Now, this will look a little bit strange when you first start doing this, because this colour's going to look quite bold on his face just here. So you just need to start painting around the teeth as well, and just down between them, being careful not to get on the red of his face around it. And as I say, it will look a little bit strange in this first colour, but once we've added the shade and highlight to it, this will look absolutely fine. Now the teeth are done, there's just one more colour to base coat before we move on to the all-over shade. And this colour is Adaddon Black. Now this is actually for his carapace, and I know the carapace in this colour scheme looks like it's dark blue, but it's actually a bit of an illusion. It's actually black with blue highlights, and you'll see this effect taking place as we get further on. So Adaddon Black, and using a standard brush to apply this, and the method for doing this is just like all the other base coats. You're just looking to get a solid colour all over these areas. So for this, you're looking at these hardened plates of bone down here, all the way down his back, down the top of his head. So you just need to apply your colour over here as neatly as you can as you get close to the skin. Now finished applying the Adaddon Black to all the carapace and onto the carapace bits and the gun as well, we've finished all the base coats in the miniature and we're ready to apply the all-over shade. Now what I recommend you do when you're painting your unit is paint all the miniatures up to this stage by doing all the Mephiston Red and all of them first, then all the Skavenblight Dinge and so on. And that way you're kind of creating a production line. It's the most efficient way to do a unit like this. And when you're ready, the colour you need is Nuln Oil, and I'm going to be applying this using a wash brush because you need to put on quite a lot of it. So get plenty loaded on your brush and just create a little kind of puddle of it on your palette here. That way you can control how much you've got a bit more accurately than straight out of the pot. Load a good amount on your brush and, well, what you're looking to do is paint this all over the model. So you need to make sure you're working it into all the little details across all of him, and I mean everywhere on him, even on the carapace. You can see it settling there. But the trick to this part really is making sure that you're applying enough that it settles in the recesses, but not so much that it starts running off the model. You don't want it to be dripping off, because that way you can get these kind of blobs forming towards the bottom of the figure. So apply this all over the miniature, then give it plenty of time to dry. And it could take anything up to an hour, but it is important it's completely dry before you start the next stage. I've given the shade plenty of time to dry, and you can see it's toned down the model quite a lot, but that's okay, because we're going to brighten it up very quickly. And the first stage for doing this, well, you need Mephiston Red once again, but this time I'm going to be applying it using a standard brush. Now, when you get your paint ready this time, thin it down with just a little bit more water than we did previously, just to thin the paint a bit more than before. And make sure you don't have too much on your brush. I'm going to be just twisting my brush again to get a good tip on there to give me lots of control. And what I'm looking to do here is paint on most of the skin, but not all of it. I'm just going to be leaving the darker recessed areas with the darker red showing through. So around the back of the head, for example, I'm going to be painting most of it, but just leaving those kind of circles along there with the darker red showing through. And the same is true around all here, around the jaw. You see, wherever the shade settled, I'm just avoiding those parts. So you need to do this all over his skin. So take your time with this part, because there's a fair amount to do, like down his arms, for example. Just avoid all those joints as you get to them. And you'll see once you've done this, it'll really brighten up all that skin. Remember, just be as neat as you can at this stage. Now I've finished that layer, you can see the skin's really brightened up. And also we've got loads of definition now because of all that shading we did earlier on. So with that done, the next stage is to add a highlight to the skin. And for this, the colour you need is Evil Sun Scarlet. And I'm going to apply this using my fine detail brush, because the technique I'm using here is called edge highlighting. And for this, you need as much control as possible. So thin your paint down once again, a bit of water, and just make sure you've got a nice tip on your brush. And what you're looking to do here is paint lines following all the most defined areas of detail. So on his face, for example, I'm looking for all the sharper parts, like around his eye, for example. And I just paint lines following all these areas here. And doing this really makes all these features really stand out from a distance. So you need to do this all over his body, so around all the face and also on the tops of his arms, for example, like a little line just running along there. And you'll need to do it along all the ridges and all these edges around the joints too. Along the ribs as well, just a line following them down like that. And on the tail, you're just looking to paint a line just running along the top of it like that. And with that highlight done, the flesh is now finished. And we can move on to the next major colour on this miniature, which is going to be the carapace. And this is where you're going to see what I mean about the carapace actually being black. It's going to appear dark blue when we're done. The first colour you need is Sotek Green. And this I'm going to be applying with my fine detail brush. And, well, I'm going to be doing another edge highlight, really. So just like when we did with the red a minute ago, you just need to thin your paint and make sure that you've got a really good tip on your brush. So a little bit of water, a twisting technique. And what you need to do is paint this around the edges all these bony plates. So you can actually use a side of your brush here because this detail is so pronounced. What you can do is just angle your brush just like this and run it down the bone like that, and you see very quickly and very easily get a neat straight line running around the edge of it. Now for those kind of lines of growth going down the bone, what you need to do is, well, once again, make sure your paint is thinned with a little bit of water. I've seen people trying to do this before and finding it really difficult, and it's simply because their paint's been too dry. So get your paint thinned on your palette with a bit of water. About that should be fine. Get that fine tip. And what you need to do is angle your model so that you can paint in kind of like downward flicking motions, really. So what you do is just lightly start running your brush along it like that. And you can see the pattern starts to build up. So it's just a matter of doing this until you get to a point that you're happy with. So just take your time with this stage and you'll see the pattern building up. With the Sotek Green done, you can see now we've got the impression of the carapace being a really dark blue. Now you can of course just leave it here because, well, it looks great, but if you want to go a little bit further, you can do, and to do this you need Temple Guard Blue. Now I do recommend that you do this if you're painting one of the larger creatures, so something like a Hive Tyrant or a Carnifex. This looks really good if you do it on that. So what you need to do is prepare your paint just like we did before, so not very much on your brush, and a good tip on there, and thin the paint with a little bit of water. And what you're looking to do with this is paint it on, well, the more sharper areas on the carapace. So, for example, I'm just going to be looking at the top here and just adding a little bit of this lighter blue just towards the top. So on there and down the middle as well, just like that. So you just do this in all the corners, really. Now, when it comes to doing those lines that go down the carapace, you don't need to do so much. Just two or three down each side will do just fine. It just really sort of highlights a few parts of it. Now, of course, once you've done this, there's really not much more left to do. And now that I've finished that final highlight on the carapace, well, the two main areas of colour on the model are done, and all that remains are just a few more details. Now, for these, you're going to need three different colours. First of all, I'm going to do all the claws and the gun, and for this, I'm going to do an edge highlight using Stormvermin Fur. After that, I'm going to do another edge highlight, this time on the teeth, using Screaming Skull. Then finally, I'm going to use a small amount of Averland Sunset to paint the eyes. So for all these stages, I'm going to be using a fine detail brush. And, well, this is another edge highlight, first of all, with a gun. So this is my Stormvermin Fur here. Just make sure I've got that good tip on the brush, not too much on there. And, well, what I'm looking to do is paint all the sharper edges of detail. So on the gun, for example, around the magazine, I'm just looking at painting a line going down either side there, just like that, following all these kind of details. Once you've done the highlight on the gun and the claws, the next thing to do is use Screaming Skull to highlight the teeth. And once again, I've got a fine detail brush here. This is all about just painting some lines just on the most raised parts. And with the teeth done, the last thing to do is to get a small amount of Averland Sunset just to paint the eyes. And you just need a very small amount to do this, so keep your hands as steady as possible and just paint them like that. And of course, don't forget that some of the guns have eyes in them too, so make sure you get them all. Now, once you've done this, all that's left to do is to base the miniature. And of course, I recommend that you base it in the same way to match the rest of your army. So there you go, that's how you paint a Termagant for Hive Fleet Behemoth. And as you've seen, painting Tyranids is actually lots of fun because it's really easy to get a great result. So when you're painting a squad of miniatures, remember that a great technique to use is to set up a production line. This is a very efficient way to paint a squad of miniatures. Also, another great thing to paint a squad is to apply as many base coats as you can and then shade them all in one go. And finally, I know I often say it, but just be as neat as you can. The neater you are, the better the final result's going to be. And this is particularly true when you're doing all the highlights towards the end. Now, I hope you found something really useful in this video. Remember, everything I've shown you will be useful not just for Tyranids, but for, well, any miniatures really. So, I'll see you next time.